Now will you notice, verse 6, "Now therefore, Tatnai governor beyond the river, Shether Boznai and your companions, the Aphrasachites, which are beyond the river, be ye far from thence." Listen, this is what Darius now says. "Let the work of this house of God alone, let the governor of the Jews and the elders of the Jews build this house of God in his place. Moreover, I make a decree that ye shall do to the elders of these Jews for the building of this house of God, that of the king's goods, even of the tribute beyond the river, forthwith expenses be given unto these men, that they may be not hindered." Now, this man that was governor, he had a political job over there, and he thought that by virtue of all of that and the report he'd made, that he could stop the building of this temple in Jerusalem. Now, when the decree of Cyrus was located, why, this king feels like, well, it's the law of the Medes and Persians. It can't be altered or changed. And so he immediately sends word, says, "Now look, I not only don't want you to hinder that work, but the taxes that you gather over there on that side of the river, you keep it over there to help these folk in rebuilding the temple." May I say to you that God does make the wrath of man to praise him. And this was a case of it. And we are told that they were to be given young bullocks and rams and lambs for the burnt offering of the God of heaven. And you notice again the reference, he's called the God of heaven. He's now returned back to his place. "Wheat, salt, wine, and oil, according to the appointment of the priests which are at Jerusalem, let it be given them day by day without fail." In other words, you're to help them now and not hinder the work at all. And what a decree this was. Fact of the matter is, there was a very severe penalty on anyone now who would attempt to hinder the work and who did not help them in all that they were to do. Now we're told here in verse 14, "And the elders of the Jews builded, and they prospered through the prophesying of Haggai the prophet and Zechariah the son of Iddo." And I wish right now I could turn to those two prophets. They are marvelous. We call them minor prophets. Well, they were batting in the major leagues, even if you call them minor prophets. And we're told they builded and finished it according to the commandment of the God of Israel, and according to the commandment of Cyrus and Darius and Artaxerxes, king of Persia. Now we're told this house was finished on the third day of the month Adar, which was in the sixth year of the reign of Darius. And the children of Israel, the priests, the Levites, the rest of the children of the captivity, kept the dedication of this house of God with joy. Now, who's the rest of the captivity? Those are the 10 tribes that a great many people today have lost. They didn't get lost. They're not lost. Verse 17, "And they offered at the dedication of this house of God 100 bullocks, 200 rams, 400 lambs, and for a sin offering, for whom? For all Israel." Two tribes? Judah? No. 12 tribes, my friend. For all Israel, 12 he-goats, according to the number of the tribes of Israel. Now, don't tell me today that 10 of them got lost and they've ended up yonder in Great Britain and a few of them came over on the Mayflower to this country. That's just simply not true. The record here is very clear that at this time they were not lost. And if they are lost, then all 12 are lost because they're together here. And we'll see that again a little later. Now we're told that they kept the Passover. And what is that Passover? That speaks of the death of Christ. Christ, our Passover, is offered for us. And they gathered around this great Passover feast, which means they're gathering around the person of Jesus Christ, and it's according to the word.